Hi, this is Susan Broder from Speak Languages and Travel the World, here to help you improve your English with minimum effort and maximum benefit. And today, I'd like to talk to you about why translating is very bad for your fluency and generally for learning to speak English well. Now, why is that? Before I tell you the answer to that, I'd like you to click here on the link and download my free fluency exercises, which at no cost will help you improve your fluency just driving your car to work or doing household chores. You'll be able to practice these audio exercises and also speaking exercises without stealing any free time from your free time activities, your family and friends. So, translating is really, really bad for your fluency because in other languages, or in every language actually, the words are put together in different combinations. So no language will have the same combination of words to express an idea, to express concepts. And therefore, it makes no sense to translate because, yes, you will have the exact meaning very often word for word. But when you want to reuse that expression, you'll put together the words that you have in your mind, you'll translate them and not necessarily put them together in the correct order. So what does that mean? I'll give you an example. For years, I've been fighting a problem that many of my students have because very often at a certain point, they have to either talk about themselves or write about themselves. And the typical phrase that comes out is, my family is composed of four members, or my family consists of four people. In any case, always wrong compositions of words. So, what should one really say? One should really say, there are four people in my family. That's what a native speaker would say. Or, there are four of us in my family. Or my family is made up of four people. The other words are technically and grammatically correct, but no native speaker would say that. So it makes no sense to use words that don't sound natural, that no native speaker would say. That's why translating is really, really bad. And the only way to overcome this is to immerse yourself in the language, first of all. But secondly, to make sure that you use definitions rather than translations. So when you don't know what something means, look it up in the dictionary of the same language. So in my case, English, and look for the definition or ask a person what it means by explaining to you what it means, defining it. So at that point, you'll have the expression embedded in your mind in the correct format and you won't make a mistake. You'll just learn, there are four people in my family, for example, or there are four of us in my family. And you won't even think of using any other expression. Translating should be used at a very, very high level when you're really, really advanced to understand abstract concepts which are not so easy to define. So I'm not saying that translating is absolutely wrong, but certainly it should be used for the very occasional word which doesn't fit in any context that you can define and understand. So practically, very rarely. Another example I can give you is that there was an expression when I moved to Germany which I presumed meant something and I never ever translated it because it fitted into every context really, really well. And after 3 years, this word didn't fit into that particular context. And so I went and looked it up in the dictionary. And what I had interpreted as its meaning was 90% of the time correct. But there was a 10% possibility of using a meaning which was similar to that, but not identical. And that's where I needed to use the dictionary because it didn't make any sense to me. But that took place 3 years after having heard and used this expression perfectly correctly in all contexts. So, translating, forget it. Try and immerse yourself in the language, listen to programs, sing songs, but also looking at the lyrics. So you pick up what I call blocks or chunks of language. And it's the chunks you have to learn in the correct sequence of the words. And then you won't make any mistakes because you'll be saying the complete chunk correctly, just very naturally, the same way as any native speaker would do so. Therefore, that's what I recommend. Don't translate. Get to pick up the language by listening, repeating, and just absorbing the language, just as children would do. Children absorb the language without translating. They just pick it up from the context. And that's what I recommend you do. And if you think that this was a very useful video, please subscribe here to my YouTube channel. And I look forward to seeing you in the next video. And that's all. Bye for now. Goodbye.